Bye.
Thank you.
Here and Maggie, thank you for the nice intro. Appreciate that very much. And so let's start tonight off and let's talk about this thing that I'll be blowing all night long. I said thing. It's not what the G stands for. Now, this is. Do we know what this is? Do you know what this is? What instrument? What is it? That's a horn. That's vague, no? Anybody else got any ideas? It's not a golden flute. My golden flute comes out after midnight, so we're not going to see that unless you stick around late, then you might see it. But this is a soprano saxophone, okay? Soprano saxophone. By the way, this is my high school saxophone. Same one I've had since high school, which proves scientifically, you blow something for 40 years, you're going to stay together. You're welcome, fellas. You're welcome. Every guy in the audience is going, see, honey? See? He knows what he's talking about. We've been playing together over 30 years on stage. How great. How great. In fact, I'm very proud to say the two of us are high school friends and we played in our high school jazz band together. And everyone's going to be featured tonight, so you're going to get to know every one of us on stage. And as I introduce them, you'll find out who my high school friend is. But it's Robert on piano. Now you know. And when we went to high school, back whenever it was. We were very lucky that we had music programs in our public school system. We didn't go to any fancy music schools. We just went to public school. Our high school music teachers showed us how to play these instruments, and we practiced because we thought if we practiced hard enough, just maybe, we might become professional musicians someday. And then we thought, well, you know, why don't we just dream as big as we can dream? So we started to practice even more. We thought if we practice super hard, maybe someday, way in the future, on a Friday night, we might be able to play at some hotel. Down in Laguna Beach, California. Where everyone? This isn't Laguna?
Newport.
See, I told you they'd get mad if I said that. Anyway, our high school dream is to be here playing for you. Thank you for making our dreams come true, everyone. We really appreciate it. Hope you have fun tonight. for having us here, and Maggie, thank you for the nice intro. Appreciate that very much. And so let's start tonight off, and let's talk about this thing that I'll be blowing all night long. I said thing. It's not what the G stands for. Now, this is... Do we know what this is? Do you know what this is? What instrument? What is it? That's a horn. That's vague, no? Anybody else got any ideas? It's not a golden flute. My golden flute comes out after midnight, so we're not going to see that. Unless you stick around late, then you might see it. But this is a soprano saxophone, okay? Soprano saxophone. By the way, this is my high school saxophone. Same one I've had since high school, which proves scientifically, you blow something for 40 years, you're going to stay together. You're welcome, fellas. You're welcome. Every guy in the audience is going, see, honey? See? He knows what he's talking about. We've been playing together over 30 years on stage. How great. How great. In fact, I'm very proud to say the two of us are high school friends, and we played in our high school jazz band together. And everyone's going to be featured tonight, so you're going to get to know every one of us on stage. And as I introduce them, you'll find out who my high school friend is. But it's Robert on piano. Now you know. And when we went to high school, back whenever it was, we were very lucky that we had music programs in our public school system. We didn't go to any fancy music schools. We just went to public school. Our high school music teachers showed us how to play these instruments, and we practiced because we thought if we practiced hard enough, just maybe, we might become professional musicians someday. And then we thought, well, you know, why don't we just dream as big as we can dream? So we started to practice even more. We thought if we practice super hard, maybe someday, way in the future, on a Friday night, we maybe might be able to play at some hotel down in Newport Beach, California. See, I told you they'd get mad if I said that. Anyway, our high school dream is to be here playing for you. Thank you for making our dreams come true, everyone. We really appreciate it. Hope you have fun tonight.
house.
Thank you.
and more sex education right here. This is awesome. We're talking about ballads, okay? The number one ballad was done in 1959 by the infamous John Coltrane. Okay, now you like me. Anyway, this song we want to give to you right now, 1959, and John Coltrane did this beautiful ballad that he wrote. We're going to give it to you right now. When it's finished, just feel the vibe that you will become jazz aficionados, because now you know the most famous jazz ballad in history is called Naima.
Bring it up!
Is going to continue right now. We gave you the 1950s just there with John Coltrane. We gave you the 1960s with Stan Getz. I've got the 80s, 90s, and beyond cover, so we don't have to worry about that part. But we didn't give you any songs from the 1970s, so we're going to give you now the number one instrumental of the 1970s. And if you're about my age, you will recognize it instantly. If you're younger, you're going to like it because it's a fun song. And we're all going to appreciate it because, thank God, it was not written by Michael Bolton.
Yeah.
White, but he's white. And that is Dale Johnson on the bass guitar. All right, I'm going to take a few minutes and introduce you to the guys, and then we're going to give away that saxophone right after that. So I made an announcement before the show that we're raffling off the sax. So if anybody doesn't have a raffle ticket and they want a raffle ticket for the saxophone, Bobby's got them right there. You got a few extra minutes, so I'll leave it to you to figure that out while I do the intros, and then we will give away that saxophone. So let me start with my high school friend on piano. I want to formally introduce you to him. We went to Franklin High School in Seattle, and every morning we played in our jazz band together. Both of us graduated with honors. Class of That's Robert Damper on piano right there. Earlier, I told you that we've been playing together 30 plus years. Our guitar player is physical evidence of this because when we first started playing together, his hair was longer than mine. That's John Raymond on guitar from Seattle. You know, our drummer, I'm going to introduce him now to you, but I want to also let you know that he has the hardest job of all of us tonight.
Because
I'm basically playing the sax the way I normally play. You know, it's mic'd and whatever, you know, the sound engineer. We're there for exactly the same amount of time. We do the same amount of reps. We just get a different result. So, I'm going to tell you something, and I'll bring it right back to him, because it's all about him. So, as much as we love being here, and we do in Newport Beach, we love being here. And last night we were in San Diego, and a few weeks ago we were somewhere in, I don't know, down in Mexico. I think we played Mexico City. We're going to be in Asia. In fact, our tour is just starting right now, and we're going to be touring right through the first of the year. We're going to be going to Asia, we're going to Europe, we're going to South Africa, we're going all over the world. But we've been doing this for decades. We've been doing this for decades, and we have seen for the last four decades all of the great musicians on our planet. We've seen them, we've hung out with them, we've worked with them, we play with them. I can tell you this, the number one percussionist is right here tonight, and that's Ron Powell right there on percussion.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.